Good afternoon, guys. If you are someone making videos and thinking to switch to Mac from Windows, this is the video for you. I have been making mainly RC vehicle videos, as you see, and I'm making simple edits since 4 or 5 years on Vegas Pro on Windows. But I have decided to switch Mac. This is the first time I have ever used a Macintosh system computer, and also this is the first time I am using the Final Cut Pro video editing program, which is especially optimized for MacBook by Apple. I'm trying to learn that because unfortunately the Vegas Pro is not available on MacBooks. And it's also really frustrating to use Final Cut Pro after Vegas Pro, because Final Cut Pro definitely is not a user-friendly program for the beginners. Even for a simple transition, you have to open a menu, select your transition, and drag it and drop it to the timeline. But actually, it is not that hard in Vegas Pro. So anyway, this is a topic of another video. I'm going to make also a comparison video with the Vegas Pro and the Final Cut Pro. But today, our topic is the rendering ability of this tiny MacBook. This is MacBook Air M1, the base model, but I have upgraded the RAM to 16 gigabytes. And it has a 256 gigabytes of storage. So the video I am going to render now is going to be published on my channel, as I have made that video as a comparison of iPhone 13 Pro and Canon M50 DSLR camera, which is better or which performs better. You can see the difference. I made some split screens, transitions, color corrections. This is actually a little bit heavy load for this machine. So first I would like to show you my project, the details, which files I have used, what kind of edit that I made. It's an average editing process for average users, and I know 90% of us are average users, average editors, not professionals actually. So this is going to be a real life rendering video. If you are thinking to buy a base model MacBook Air and thinking to use it on your video editing process. Okay, let's open up the project and see what is in there. Okay guys, let's open up the project, Final Cut Pro, and I am still using the trial version of Final Cut Pro because I am not sure if I am going to use it for as my permanent editing video program. If I don't like this one or I cannot figure it out, I hope I am going to. I will try the DaVinci Resolve or the Premiere Pro, but I am really hoping that I can deal with this program. So let's see what I have here. So the beginning of the video, this footage is recorded by iPhone SE, so the image quality was not good and I had to make some color corrections on this one. So this is the first additional task that this computer will deal. And then we have a 4K 60fps footage from the iPhone 13 Pro and a 4K 30fps footage from Canon M50, because the maximum FPS at 4K Canon M50 can record is 30fps. Also, these titles are3D animation titles, so they are also an additional task for the Final Cut Pro and the MacBook Air's M1 chip and the GPU. Each comparison has two titles, and these titles are continuing all along the video. 4K 60fps, 4K 30fps, two videos in one at the same time in the timeline, and it has a split screen as you can see. It's also an additional task for the system. Same stabilization test, and after that, as you can see, I have a 180p 30fps ProRes footage from the iPhone 13 Pro. It's also an additional task for the system. And also at 180p 30fps footage from the Canon M50, but Canon M50 doesn't have RAW feature or ProRes features. That's why it's the standard footage from the Canon M50. And also 4K 30fps from iPhone 13 Pro and 4K 30fps from Canon M50 next to each other. Digital zoom from iPhone 13 Pro and Canon M50. Cinematic footage performance from Canon and iPhone 13 Pro also. And again, the low light performance for both cameras. So we have lots of codecs in one timeline, transitions also, yes, there are some transitions, titles, color grading, some load heavy tasks for this base model of the MacBook Air. So let's see how it performs while rendering this project. The entire project is 7 minutes and 38 seconds. How long will it take for this MacBook Air 16GB version will need to render this project out? Before we start rendering, I would like to measure the temperature of the computer now. Let's use this heat gun. So it says 26.5 Celsius degrees. And let's see what will be the temperature at the end of this rendering process. Okay, let's start rendering. Share, export file. And we are going to use computer and better quality, which is H.264, 4K. So we are choosing H.264 because YouTube asking us to use this codec, which is better and easier to process. Okay, let's set our stopwatch and start rendering. The rendering has started. And I also would like to turn on the activity monitor so we can actually see how much RAM the Final Cut Pro using. See, the computer is already using 13 gigabytes of RAM, so I am really happy that I get the 16GB RAM version of the new M1 MacBook Air. Okay, let's see how much time it is going to get to render this out. It's been 5 minutes and 40 seconds. 39% is done. Let's measure the temperature again. So we started with 26.5 degrees and at the moment the heat is 29.2 degrees. It's been approximately 60 minutes and 66% of rendering is done. And let's see what is the temperature is. The temperature is 31.8 degrees at the moment. Okay, it's been 20 minutes and 30 seconds. The project is at 76% done. And the temperature, sorry. Is now 32.3 Celsius degrees. And we have started with 26.5 degrees. It is approximately gone up about 6 Celsius degrees among the rendering process. So I'm just going to keep recording because after 80% or something like 83%, it just finishes the project. A 7 minutes and 38 seconds 4K 60 FPS project in the timeline. It's been 22 minutes approximately. There are different kind of videos, different kind of codecs, different FPS rates, 3D title animations, transitions, color grading, music, and this is how MacBook Air M1 base model with 16 gigabytes of RAM performs 78%. Also, we have split screens in the timeline. With this load, actually, this computer performs quite well when you consider also about its price, which is around, I think I paid $1,200. Normally, it's, you know, $999, but when you add the 6 gigabytes of RAM, extra $200 will be added, and it's $1,200. I was really not sure if I should switch from the Windows to Mac. Yes, to be honest, Windows is the most user-friendly system, and you are going to miss too many things when you switch to Mac. But the actual reason I switched to MacBook with the M1 chip is the rendering performance, because I do render videos, and somehow these tiny computers are working better than some of the most powerful Windows computers. There is no lagging in the timeline because of the cache files, the huge cache files, but you can delete them. So yes, I think I made a right decision, 80%, I'm sure. So you should be really consider about the way that you are going to use your computer, because if you need useful friendly system, you should stick with the Windows. But if you want more performance for your workflow, MacBook is actually the Macintosh system is better. But I am still keeping my Windows computer because I know in some cases I'm going to need it. 81%, 24.30 seconds. And I am also going to make a first time Mac user video in the upcoming weeks. So I'm going to tell you all my experiences, what I have missed, what is frustrating about the system, what is better about this computer and the system. Because it is really a big decision to switch from Windows to Mac. And Final Cut Pro is using 6.32 gigabytes of memory. And the Pro Transcoder tool is, I think, is also about the rendering process. It's using a 630 megabytes. The total RAM usage of the computer at the moment is 9.68 gigabytes because I don't touch anything. I'm not multitasking at the moment. I am not surfing on the internet, or I am not trying to create a thumbnail for the video, so I'm not using the GPU also. It generally finishes rendering after 83%. I hope it is going to make the same thing so we can stay under 30 minutes. But it's really a heavy load for this computer, 4K, 60 FPS.
There are some ProRes files, 60 FPS files, 30 FPS files, transitions, color grading. We are very close to the finish line. 27 minutes, 20 seconds, 83%. The temperature stabilized at 32.5 degrees. So we get an exact 6 degrees of more temperature. Still 83%. And there is no screen recording. The computer is not plugged into the charger. 84%. And we are heading to 30 minutes. I know this video came very long, but I should have show you what the real life using experience of this MacBook Air M1, if you are trying to decide to get this one or not. And I really suggest you, if you are going to use this for video encoding, you should get the 16 gigabytes of RAM version, or you can wait for the new MacBook Air with the M2 chip. Yes, our video is rendered out and the total rendering time is 29 minutes and 48 seconds. The total usage of the RAM from all systems is 8.32 gigabytes at the moment. Let's close it out. I have saved it to Canon Razer iPhone, untitled project, get info, 2.95 gigabytes, H.264, 3840 by 2160, 4K 60 FPS. Video, let me show you the FPS rate also from the player. To see the FPS rate, press Command and I, as I remember, yes. Here we can see the FPS rate. Here, encoded FPS 60. So, okay guys, there we go. If you are thinking to get this computer, this is the actual video rendering performance for an average user like me. I hope this video would give you some idea to spend your money on. Okay, please don't forget to share your thoughts about my video. And if you like the video, please just hit the like button. And if you would subscribe to my channel to support me, I will be very happy. As always, thank you for watching. Have a good day.